ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who will be fronting the grid.
Verstappen, Ricciardo, and Carlos Sainz.
With qualifying complete, all that remains...
I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
Again then at Le Castellet for another round of this year's Formula One World Championship. Renault took their first French Grand Prix win all the way back in the inaugural race in 1906, but it was another 73 years before they could take their second. I'm sure Alpine will be pushing hard to delight the local fans here today. Mastering a lap of Paul Ricard means getting to know 15 corners, 6 left and 9 right, for an overall lap distance of 3.6 miles. The two halves of the long Mistral Strait are separated by a heavy braking zone into a potential overtaking hotspot at the Chicane Nord. And watch out for the drivers running onto the distinctive coloured stripes, which are low in grip and highly abrasive. Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he starts from pole position. And P2 goes to Daniel Ricciardo, a strong showing from the Australian. Considering the rest of the grid, we have...
This is our engine supplier's home Grand Prix. Let's give them a race worth watching.
Join us as the round of the world.
to see a lot of power. Verstappen behind. Okay, the gap behind is 3.2 seconds. They're on old softs. Your pit window opens next lap. There are 10 laps to go. You want to pit this lap, so push now. To start falling away soon. Speed now. Let's get some heat into those tires. two places at once. George is going in for his stop. Time penalty for that last incident. You're sat in P2. Bottas is ahead of you. Gap to car in front is 10.2 seconds. They're on old softs. Tsunoda behind. Our gap behind is 1.8 seconds. They're on old softs. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. 7 laps to go. As things stand, we'll be 6th in the championship. P gap to the car behind is 2.5 seconds. Stand will be 6th in the championship. laps of fuel remaining. Teammate by 18.5 seconds. Gap to teammate behind is 19.5 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. They're in eighth. The time last lap was a 1 minute 35.5. Position, front of the pack. Verstappen is behind you. The gap behind us is 12.1 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Just three laps to go now. Three laps. There's four laps of fuel remaining. Job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. is your final lap. Final lap of the race. Two laps of fuel left. Fantastic. You've won the Grand Prix.
A great race then, and a fantastic victory here at Paul Ricard. Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
Well, I honestly feel it was down to the driver and car today. I mean, we can talk driver skill all day, but if you don't have a solid team to back that, you're never going to get anywhere.
Well, And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
I have to give it to the Golden Boy. They demonstrated a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, as well as showing a lot of maturity and patience in difficult situations.
It's time to check out the constructor standings. No change in the top spot, but with today's points, their hold on the lead is getting weaker. There was also a strong showing from the McLaren team today, as they make their way up the standings. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time? Be sure to...
Amazing performance out there. I'm sure you're pretty happy with that. You really looked in control of your car out there. Your team must be thrilled. Did you feel that things went well for you today? What was the secret ingredient for your performance today? Do you have any comments about the collisions? Appreciate your time.